Hello guys, my name is Chef Steven and I'm taking you through food cost, and we are going specifically through how to come up with menu prices. And our dish for today is roast chicken with fries. And down here we say portion is one, item description, quantity and unit cost. The item description is what do we need, the ingredients we require for this, for the whole dish. Quantities is what grams do we need to produce the dish. Then the unit cost is how much will it cost per each unit cost. So as we see, the whole chicken is already there, 1.4 kilograms, which is 14,000. The Irish is 1 kg, which is 2,000. This is Ugandan shillings, which is giving us up to a total food cost of 17,030 shillings. So the total cost, which is already here, 70,030 shillings, we add VAT to it, which is 18%. So we say 17,000 divided by 18%, which is the VAT, which will give us this. Then we also add the service charge, which is 5%. So the 17,030 shillings divided by the 5% of the VAT gives us 851 shillings, 0.5, giving us a total food cost plus its taxes all of 20,947 shillings. So to come up with the menu price, we say our menu price equals the food cost, which is the 20,000, divided by the food cost percentage. At this level, we are using the 35% food cost percentage. So divided by the food cost percentage time is 100%, 100. So, which is equals to 20,947 divided by 35%, which is our food cost, time is 100. It gives us 59,850 shillings. This is for the whole chicken. So if we cut the chicken into quarters, we will get four portions. So we say, if we are dividing for a smaller restaurant which is selling in quarters, so we say we divide the total amount of this by four, which is giving us 15,000 per quarter chicken with chips. So there is another simpler way for the same methodology, getting to the same menu price, but at this level now we are using the simplest method. Like we only get the whole ingredients which are needed, which is our whole roast chicken, which is the whole chicken, which is at 14,000. Irish potatoes, which is the 2,000. Then we are adding, instead of adding all the ingredients we are adding there for production, we are adding the food cost, the production cost of 15%. Production cost of 15% of the 16,000, which is the total here, which will give us 2,400. So 2,400 is the production cost, total production cost. So we also add VAT, which is 18%, which will give us here 18% of the 16,000, will give us 2,880. We also add the service charge. Service charge is 5%, just like the other side, which will give us 800 shillings. So the total cost of production now is 22,080 shillings. So when we come to our menu price here, our menu price equals food cost, which is this, divided by the food cost percentage, which is our 35% times 100, which we see here. The 22,000, which is this, divided by 35% times 100. So now it gives us 63,857, not 8 shillings, 57, not. So we round it back to 53,000 shillings. We avoid the decimals. So if we are getting now, if we are cutting this to quarters, we divide by 4 again, which is giving us 15,800 shillings. 15,800 shillings. Remember the other side we got 15,000 shillings, and here we are getting 15,800 shillings. So you see, this is a lesser, it involves less work, but you get almost the same level according to the percentages and prices. And it is easier for you. You can do so many dishes at a certain time, which is manageable, other than involving every ingredient you want to use, then to come up with the price. So this is how it goes along. On that note, I just want to highlight, most of the time people ask, out of the 100, where is the 35% coming from? What is the other? Every restaurant, every hotel has its own food cost percentage which they operate at. There is always an allowance of 2% plus 2% or -2%. But at this level, we are using the 35%. The 35% or plus the 35, the 45, the 55, whichever percentage one hotel or restaurant is working at, is the material cost that the restaurant operates at. What you're putting in the whole production of that dish, that is what is produced at. So we use the 35% as the material cost production of everything we are putting there. Then the rest, of course, out of 100, we have the other one, 65%, if you've removed the 35%. So the 65%, we look at it as the gross profits, what we are looking up to, the gross profit. So when we look at the gross profit, we are looking at the 65%. This is where now we shall be getting out the labor costs, the overhead costs, and the other costs which are helping the place run. It is out of that now that we come to the net profits, where now that is now management that will be running the owners of the restaurant. We'll understand the net profit is what is taken to the bank or what is burnt and is reinvested to the organization. By the way, the prices I've been using all along, I got them from Bringo Fresh website. They deal in Kampala, they are vegetable and fruit suppliers and also meat. They are very flexible suppliers and they have better prices. So I used their price list. I got it from their website and I used their price list to cost this, and that is how it has been. Thank you so much for listening. Have a good day.